right, y'all, we're about to get started. Before we do you have any requests? Got lower back already?
Yep.
Anything else? Maybe some glutes if you came to camp today? anything else? We'll pretty much go through the whole body, but I tend to hang a little longer in places that need it the most. If not, we'll see what I decide halfway through. Sometimes really on the fly. But yeah, let's get started. You can roll onto your back. Bring your feet together, let your knees fall wide. Your hands can come down by your hips. You can go palms up, palms down. You can place one hand on your heart, one on your stomach, whatever feels nice right now. If you're new to deep stretch, today your focus is just to relax. There's not necessarily a right or wrong way to get into a posture or pose. But you'll have to listen to your body and tell you what it needs. If you're feeling uncomfortable, if you're feeling some discomfort, then your job is to talk about it. We'll typically hold poses for at least 90 seconds, sometimes up to 3 or 4 minutes. Your goal is not to force the stretch. The benefits of the stretch come regardless. Today is much more of a mental game than a physical game. Can you get your body to relax? Can you talk yourself through that uncomfortable spot?
This is for the girls that don't need no makeup when they wake up. For the ones who rock at least fronts, you know, I ain't gonna say nothing. Hashtag real sick. You fresh off the breakups for the introverts. We don't gotta say much. If you feel free, then you should live your life. Real, real, less.
Take a deep breath in, bring your knees together, place your feet flat to the floor, and grab your block. We're going to set up a hip bridge. So just like you would for a glute raise, feet under the knees, lift your hips up, and then you can choose your height to be your smallest, medium, and highest here. Everyone should be able to get to the medium height to start there. If you have the space, go all the way to the top, but you're gonna sit your pelvis right on top of that block. Make sure it's not on your low back, make sure your hips rest. And then from there, relax the back. Let gravity take hold, let your low back fall towards the floor. Every time you find yourself in a new pose today, I want you to focus a little bit on your breath. Start to lengthen the breath. Just relax your body with your breath. You may notice if you get to a point later on that's uncomfortable that your breath will get much quicker. And that's just typically a sign that your body's uncomfortable. Do your best to slow it down and the rest of your body will follow along. If you got the feeling, From here, if you're on the highest setting, I want you to lift your hips and set it down to the medium height. If you're already on that medium height, you can just hang out. We're gonna add in a hip flexor stretch here. So let your hips rest on the block and then pull your right knee into your chest. You should start to feel that stretch in your left hip flexor. If you feel comfortable with it, start to slide your left foot out across the floor, extending it all the way out. Next exhale, pull the knee a little closer to the chest. You just pull your left foot back in. Slowly release your right foot to the floor. We're just going to switch sides. Reset, pull the left knee into the chest. Give a nice big hug in. Once you're comfortable there, start to extend your right leg out. Pull your right foot in, flat to the floor, slowly release your left foot. With both feet flat to the ground, squeeze your butt, lift your hips, and release your block. From here, you're going to take your right foot, stand it up in the air, and cross your right knee over your left knee, where they're actually stacked on top of each other, not the ankle, the knee itself. And then take your arms wide across the floor, make sure shoulders are flat, and lower your legs to the left. May have to reset your shoulders to keep them flat. Once you're there, take your eye gaze to the opposite side of your knees to continue that twist all the way up the spine. If you'd like a little bit more self-assist here, you can take your left hand to your right knee and just pull that knee slightly towards the ground, keeping your right shoulder pinned down. Slowly roll the knees back up through center and reset. Place those feet flat to the floor. Extend your left foot to the ceiling this time and stack your left knee on top of your right. Hands go wide again. Roll the knees to the right side this time. Resetting the shoulders as you need. I may be wrong, but I'm not like you. No, I'm not like you.
is good old. Just my sorry. Missing the days of me forgiving you.
Slowly roll back to center. Pull both knees into your chest. Give them a nice big hug in. Tuck in the chin. And then give me a little rock forward and back until you rock up to a seated position. All right, so today we'll start. We'll move on to some hamstrings. And we'll get into some hips some more. Let's go feet just hip width apart right in front. If you'd like extra, you can use your block here. We will focus on the right side to start with. I want you to take a deep breath in. Start by flexing the feet, pull the toes back to the shins, squeeze the quads, so really tense up every muscle in your legs. And take a deep breath in, reach the arms high, wiggle the shoulders up, lengthen the spine. On the exhale, keep the legs nice and tense. I want you to drop your chest towards your right thigh. You may feel a very intense stretch right from the start. That's fine. Keep the back flat. Take a deep breath in. On your next exhale, relax your legs. Lower a little further. Try not to round the back to start with. Reach the fingers out as far as you can. If you've got more space, you want to use your block, you're welcome to drop it behind the foot. Or you just reach for the foot itself. So a lot of times here, for forward folds and stretching the hamstrings, we tend to round out the upper back, thinking that just because you're reaching further, you're going to get a better stretch. That is not necessarily the case. If you think more about pushing your chest forward, you're going to get a lot more stretch in your hamstrings because that's going to give you more hinge at your hips. So even if you don't reach with your arms at all, if you push your chest forward, you're getting more of a stretch than you would by rounding your back to the front. Once you get as far as you can, just do your best. Take deep breaths. About 90 seconds in, you should notice your muscles relax a little more. If you can move further in, feel free to do so. From here, pull your toes back towards your shins, start to flex the legs again, take a deep breath in, reach the hands high. Lengthen the spine again, turn the chest towards the left side this time, and start to tip forward. Go as far as you can. When you get to that furthest point, take a deep breath in. Exhale, relax the legs, go a little further. Thank you. Same thing one more time. Flex the toes back. Flex the thighs. Lift the arms high. This time you're going right down the middle. Reach between the legs. Reach that furthest point. Inhale. Exhale. Relax the legs. The toes may fall out a little to the sides.
Just a killer come to call from some awful dream. I close, you come up see. You just stand on the glass looking at me. But I always watch my bones of steel. And I can kill you with my bare hands.
From here, take your legs as wide as you can. We'll do one more forward fold. A little wiggle of the legs if you need. It also helps if you lift your hips and tip your pelvis forward. So kind of basically think about pulling your butt cheeks back. Out of your way, roll forward. And then from here, deep breaths in. On your exhale, just slowly walk the hands forward. Your toes will fall forward as well. Working your way down as far as you can. If you have your block, you're welcome to rest on it. You can put your forearms on your block. You can put your block under your chest. You can put your block under your forehead. Basically, any way you can get something to relax more, do it. Breath in and rise up. Take up legs if you need. Then we're going to come into a cross-legged position. We'll go right leg in front. This will be your low option. If you can go further, if you have the space, you'll bring your foot to your calf. If you go further than that, you'll bring your foot up to your knee, trying to keep both knees down and flexing your toes towards your shin. From here, a little self-assist to start with. Grab a big handful of your thigh and roll it out. So thumbs to the inside, push those hips out. A lot of times I like to have it really close to the hip flexors. Give a little pressure there and push down and out at the same time. While you're pushing down, start to press your chest forward, dropping it towards your shins, and you should start to feel that on the back side of your hips. Your chest is dropped as far as it'll go. You can just let your hands slide all the way past your thighs. Continue dropping your chest and then reach your arms out in front. And here you can use your block to rest on. Arms, chest, forehead. Bring the pain up.
love myself cause you didn't throw up in my sweatshirt. Wonder if you even noticed that that one was yours. Maybe I should've, but I never told you I'm sorry. Know that I tried, but my words always got in the way. Could you hold me without
any breath? Slowly rise up. We're just gonna switch sides. So this time your left leg starts in front. And again, choose your levels. Foot to the calf, foot to the knee, flex the toes towards the shins. And then start to press down on the thighs. Start to lower the chest to the front.
I don't remember the last time I heard from your sister. Didn't expect to, but I sort of thought that I would. Wish I could.
Just follow the same progression. Roll the thighs out. Add some extra pressure. Once you feel like your hips are settled and your chest has fallen down, release the hands.
And maybe I should have, but I never told you I miss you. I almost said it, but don't know if you feel the same. Could you hold me without any talking? We could try to go back where we started. I don't even have to stay. But if I woke up with you in the morning, I'd forget all the ways that we're broken. I don't care if you changed.
Here while we transition, feel free to do so. Then we're going to move into child's pose. So take your feet together, take your knees wide. Drop your chest down in between your knees, extend your arms long in front. And then rest your forehead to the ground. Today, I want you to take your hands and reach them back to rest on your shoulder blades. So your elbows are down, palms grab the shoulder blades, and then drop your chest down. You should feel a little stretch through your triceps this way. And release your hands and then just shift your weight forward down to your stomach. Once you've done so, just flip all the way over. We're going to move into Shavasana. So onto your back, comfortable position to lie in, where all the tension is released, no effort should be involved. Once you've found that position, I want you to close your eyes. And start to scan the body nice and slowly from the top to the bottom. Each exhale, find something to let go of. So relax the eyebrows. Knees and a little more space there. and make your way down to your jaw. Relax the jaw. Let the shoulders roll out. Let the fingers find their last resting place. Make sure the glutes and the quads are relaxed here. Then finally let your toes fall all the way out to the sides. Once everything has reached its final resting point, take your focus to your breath. Calm the mind. So the goal here is to be so enveloped and so invested in your breath and the way that it's moving, that your thoughts don't interrupt. So do your best to let your mind sit comfortably within the breath. If any thoughts do creep in, acknowledge them, push them to the side. Only focus is here and now. And using that focus, lengthen the breath on the way in, another way out. You enjoy the next few minutes. We'll come back together at the end. Thank you. I was gonna say wake yourself up, but I think she did it for you. Thanks, girl. So, as you feel necessary, begin to wake the body, make any movements, take any stretches. And as you're ready, make your way up to a seated position. So have a deep stretch. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you're feeling a little more relaxed. Try to take that with you the rest of the week. And I will see you all next time. Namaste.